What's up, Paul Savola here, and so this tutorial, what I'm gonna be talking about is how to use the new feature of YouTube cards and how you can use this for your purchases, or if you're creating products or you want to send to a blog. And this is also going to be mobile friendly, so I'll see you on the flip side and we'll see you on the tutorial. All right, welcome back to the tutorial, how to use YouTube cards. You can use this in a couple different ways, but one of the first things that you're going to want to do is you're going to want to log into YouTube and go to your video manager. And inside your back in your video manager, you'll see this new option. Last week I was not able to do this because I had family over, and I'm another five extra screaming kids. But I'm gonna show you how you can do this and a couple different features that you have inside of this. And of course, this is going to be mobile friendly, and as you've seen, YouTube with your annotations, and there's only a couple features in there that are actually mobile friendly, which is your if you go inside your annotations, the only one that you can actually use, say you're going to do a note, and is your subscribe button. I mean, that's the only one that you can use. And I don't know if they're going to come about in your side of your YouTube cards to use the actual subscribe button when you use inside of your YouTube cards. But okay, now let's actually get started. I know you came on here not to hear me yap. So one of the first things you're going to do is you're going to add a card. And you see there's four different features associated with website. This is associated with website that was on your that you associated this inside YouTube. If you've got a couple different ones, you can create a video or playlist, or this. Say you want to create a product, you just don't put in exactly the email address. I mean, not the email address, but your domain name that it is gonna go to, or your associated website. Like, let's say I wanted to put mine in here. Say I want to direct you straight to my blog and for my latest blog post, right? Then as it'll start loading, as with all these, and you get to create a call to action. Say you want to say go now to my blog, right? And then from there, you have a chance to upload an image. You can upload any image that you want. So you're gonna go to your pictures, and that's the one I've been using for my blog, actually, inside here. So then you just created a card. Wait till it loads up. So usually I usually use my blog and one of my latest playlists. So if you want to add a playlist, or you just want to add a particular video, I don't know the playlist, I'd have to go back and say you want to use this one, right? So you just create card, and for that one, that's it. And you're actually going to see that inside of that one. But for merchandise, as I said, you're gonna need the associated website. I don't have no products at this time, so I wouldn't even use this feature. And then you had fundraising. This is someone wants to contribute to your channel, to your fundraising product. If you are a nonprofit and you're just fundraising for child's, for kids, for hospitals, anything in that nature. But these are your basic five components, and you're only allowed up to five of these. So you got to kind of space them out. So if you want to space them out, so you're just going to come over here, and you see you're able to move them wherever you want. And if you want to move this one at the end, in the beginning, at the 15 second mark, at the 15, you know what I mean? But this is the basic 4 steps, and I'm hoping they're going to add a subscribe button and just get rid of the annotations directly, and probably add in and keep in the no annotation, and but you're able to use it inside of the YouTube cards. I mean, it'd be really awesome if they actually keep this feature and some of the features that you really need inside of YouTube, like the note and the subscribe button for these people subscribe to your channel, because it's a lot easier to redirect people. But then again, they might say the watermark is good enough. But from here, you can come visit my blog at possible.com and subscribe to my channel. Comment down below and tell me what you think, or if you have used this feature already. But from here, I'll see you on the flip side. I'll see you in the next video, and I'll holler at you later.